3 days grace. What an amazing demonstration of subtlety in how he transitions between more subdued sounds and gruffer, more aggressive sounds. He's really fun to listen to because everything he does is so connected and yet diverse at the same time. And he's got that really neat, reedy, gritty sound that particularly comes out when his voice is doubled. Nobody sounds quite like him. And the production that they or he uses on his voice really brings out the strengths in what he does. So I'm excited to get into this one. Let's get started. Now, in order to embrace the ways that Adam uses his voice, it's important that we have a good understanding of how to use compression in a few different ways. You can't use compression if you can't really feel how you're supposed to be supporting your voice at all times, whether you're using compression or hypercompression. So, if you want a better understanding of how to support your voice, how to use compression across your whole range, click the link below and join my free vocal course. I walk you and another student how to feel different aspects of your voice, namely support, so that you can take these types of techniques, compression, hypercompression, rangy compression, all over the place and use it with a lot of versatility, just like Adam Gontier. Also, about a decade ago, I did a cover of I Hate Everything About You for a project I was working on at the time, and it's audio only, no video, so if you'd like to hear me do that from the 10 years ago me, click the other link below, and I'll send you a copy of that. And our first example. Every time we lie awake. Okay, lots to unpack here. Every, if we just sang it all vanilla, every time I lie awake, you know, nice open, maybe proper, well supported, but there's lots more going on here that gives it the flavor and the pent up intensity that is coming off this line. Every time, just in those notes. It's not just every time, every. Now, I'm doing it a little bit more extreme than he's doing it, but what we're doing here is we're adding compression over that note. Like that, but it's really subtle. We're closing, we're squeezing our false chord area in our throat just a little bit, that area above our larynx, to provide a breathiness that is not every but we're not doing it to the point of breakup. Right? Where false chords become more prominent and tone becomes less prominent. Guys like Miles Kennedy are awesome doing this in their lower register, just like this. But Adam tends to moderate it really, really well, because if you listen, there's still that breathiness, there's still that sheen, but he's lightened up. Every time, it's not every time, it's not like that. Every time. I'm exaggerating it, but he backs off for that higher note. Every time we lie awake. Now, the other thing I want to point out is at the end of this line, notice how he handles the k. Every time we lie awake. Awake. This, believe it or not, is an extremely important thing to be able to do and work into your singing. Where we sing through our consonants, we don't just let the air stop. Every time I lie awake. There's something that happens, and I get into this way more in my course, but when you fully stop the air with the consonant, you're doing something to the equilibrium that's happening as you're dialing in your support, as you're managing your airflow. And though we don't want to be thinking about singing through every consonant, it's more of an expressive sort of thing. And certainly he's not going, oh, make sure I sing through my consonants. But when you do, you release a smoothness of transitions between different states of singing. And if you're in the habit of that, then what you do and how you control your dynamics and airflow will be easier. Like I said, I don't want to do a whole thing on just that. For more information, sign up for my course and I'll walk you through why it is indeed so cool. But for now, let's take a cue from this and practice singing through our consonants and see what happens.
Every time we lie awake.
Every time we lie awake. Compression, lightening up on that higher note. Next.
Only when I stop.
Now here, if you listen to this whole song and the progression to where we get to this point, you notice that he builds an intensity and then he really, in this case, backs off of the compression and lets it be more open.
Only when I stop.
That would be more like how he's doing it at the beginning and building in, but then he backs off and lets it be more open.
Only when I stop to think about.
That's how that subtle moderation of intensity and airflow really comes out as you listen carefully. Next. Okay, classic line. Let's get there. Part of what we're hearing is very strategic and meticulous doubling to get that nice round sound. But here's where that reedy grit comes out. There's also something going on in multiple tracks happening. So it's not just the I, it's not just that one. It's I, it's very low in the mix. And so when we're unpacking stuff like this, we want to make sure we understand those things are happening. And even though we can get some good grit and use our voices in a similar way, we don't want to forget that the sound is a produced sound. So, with that in mind, let's get there.
I, hey,
those are the notes, right? Let's approach it a few different ways.
I.
Now, for me, when I'm well supported, that is a comfortable chest note.
I.
But it's right on the edge. And when we go up to the other line here, when we go up there, that's mix. That's mix for me. And I need to know about my voice enough to recognize that going into the line. And whether he's using mix or chest, we don't really care. What we do care about is getting a similar level of intensity and connection to that line. Listen to how he approaches the very first part of it.
I, hey!
That one's coming off of an H.
I, hey!
So for me, getting to the point where I can do it cleanly and then add a little bit of distortion, that's distortion via compression with my false chord area above my larynx, and then really being able to play with it and break it up so I have the freedom to do different things with it.
I hate!
Or,
I hate!
Or,
I hate!
I should be able to approach it in a lot of different ways, but, and play with it and have fun with it, but be able to call on exactly what I want, when I want it, in terms of the level of aggression, the level of distortion. Next. Everything about you. Okay, now the first thing we want to notice here is ing and you. It's not
everything about you.
We are not leaving those open. And that's a huge part of this line. The way it rolls over the beat, the way the vowels are pronounced, it would not sound near as flowing and put together if he was singing,
I hate everything about you!
About Cho. No, it just doesn't work. It's an extra awesome thing that he has paid attention to how he sings these vowels. So with that in mind, we want to preserve that. Get that nice consistent grit in my chest resonance, but realize that I'm going to need to go up.
Everything about you. Choo choo. Everything about you.
Right? Re.
Every.
Absolutely. Keep those vowels pure. Keep, and it's going to take some feeling and placement, strategic placement things to get this right with the right vowel placement as well as resonance placement. It's a challenging line, but it's fun. Next. Now here's where we can open up in our chest a little bit more.
Do I love you?
Even there though,
you and not you. Do I love you?
Now, again, the doubling and stuff is happening here to make it sound smoother than it might be. The other thing I want to point out here is there is this, these things going on up there.
Do I love you?
Pure head voice, doubled. It really adds to the overall feeling of the lead vocal. Next.
I'm already stoned.
Okay, I love this line. It's one of my favorite Adam Gontier lines. Because of the way he just, the notes and the feeling evolves in such a short amount of time.
I'm already stoned.
I'm solid, like, well compressed, well placed.
I'm.
And then he just adds that wonderful breakup and finishes really broken up.
I'm already stoned.
Okay, so let's get there.
I'm.
Sing the whole thing. It's clean.
I'm already stoned.
Just to get the notes. Clean, head voice, chest voice. What that tells me is that I'm going to be accessing an element of mix in my voice to get there.
I'm already stoned.
He sounds like he's in all chest, but I'm going to do it in partial mix, and it's going to sound great.
I'm already stoned.
I'm all.
Just going to work that.
I'm all.
I'm going to engage my false chords to beckon that grit, right?
I am already stoned! I'm...
With a very intentional focus on that first note being clean and compressed and slightly breathy.
I'm already stoned! I'm already stoned! I'm already stoned! I'm already stoned!
Being able to call that in and out is so much fun. And it's a fun exercise to take a line and see what you can do with it. How can we play with these notes and go to extremes and then let our emotion take over and see what happens. I'm already stoned. I am already stoned. Let whatever come out, come out. I am already stoned. I am already stoned. I am already stoned. I am already stoned. These lines are really inspirational for me. Next. I can't control myself. Okay, building off of the last one, he's got that nice subtle squeeze, right? I can't control. But it's bordering on more extreme breakup. And so the way I approach this is I think about
I can't control myself.
Did it slow, add that little bit of breakup, but then go into exposing my break mode a little bit and exist in that in between to access just a hint of that extreme breakup. So
I can't control myself.
I can't control myself.
Or
I can't control myself.
There's more breakup there. Again, play with the extremes, feel it as you're experimenting, and come up with something that really feels good and emotionally connected in your voice.
I can't control myself. I can't control myself. I can't control myself.
Next.
So ripped off, so stepped on.
Okay, here we've gone a little bit the other direction. We have that
so ripped off.
Very forward, belted, and yet pure, right in your face note. And then,
so stepped on.
And then there's this silky smooth, really a reference back to the very first example where it's open, yet there's that compressed sheen that happens at the same time.
So ripped off, so stepped on.
So stepped on.
Towards the end of that, I have a desire to feel and engage a little bit of that rasp that's not grit, it's just rasp.
So ripped off.
So ripped off. So stepped on. So ripped off. So stepped on.
But again, playing with those extremes like he demonstrates so well, we can play with them and figure out what works for us, but discover also all the possibilities within these lines. Next.
Let's start a riot.
Okay, this is great. I like his open,
let's start a riot.
I mean, he's very open throat, low larynx position. And that helps with just kind of the beefiness of the line.
Let's start a riot.
Now let's is
let's.
Let.
If I were to just approach it cleanly and sheepishly,
let's start a riot.
That's how I would adjust my tone.
Let's start a riot.
Where it darkens up as the line goes on. And then we introduce the compression, we introduce the compression-based grit, and the flirting with our vocal break to get the rest of it.
Let's start a riot.
I like how he throws it up into let's.
Let's start a riot!
And he's loud and aggressive, but there's compression going on there that's giving him that rounder, smoother, squeezed
riot!
Riot! It's not just Riot! It's not that. And you can hear this Riot! You can hear that sort of incidental thing that happens with my voice. That happens because I'm putting too much on my primary chords. By adding a healthy amount of compression, a healthy amount of squeeze, a healthy amount of holding back air, I actually protect my voice from those, the evidence of going too hard on my chords.
Let's start a riot! Let's start a riot!
That's more consistent where I want it to be consistent, right?
Let's start a riot!
Let's start a riot! Let's start a riot! Let's start a riot!
But that breakup on let's is very intentional. I could smooth that out.
Let's start a riot!
But that's not what we're going for. We want that. We want that.
Let's start a riot!
And a healthy amount of compression on the other end, at the end of that line, so that we maintain that consistency, that smooth, aggressive sound. Next.
Rather feel pain.
Now here's another one of these lines where we're in our chest the whole time, but we're
rather feel
very calculated and smooth, moderately compressed,
rather feel,
and then we go up to this
pain,
but there's a whole lot more there.
Rather feel pain, rather feel pain.
I think by getting, it's not purely, what he's doing is not purely that squeezed, smoother, compressed grit. He's accessing a little bit of that incidental break thing going on. At least that's how I'm able to get it a little less dual tone-ish and more gritty and broken, which is really what we want.
Rather feel pain.
Extreme.
Rather feel pain.
Nice healthy balance, inspired by Adam Gontier. I really enjoy these videos. This one's been a long time coming. A lot of you have asked for this one. And I've been listening to 3 Days Grace for a long time, so it was fun to finally dig in this way. Again, if you'd like help with your voice, taking it to a deeper level, exploring on a more holistic basis, compression across all of your range, what it means to truly dial in your support, click that link below and join my free vocal course. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and let me know what other videos you'd like me to do. And one more time, you can download my cover of I Hate Everything About You by following another link below in the video info. See you for more.